wanted to have a house where I could hang all my work over the years, and this is, I finally arrived at that accomplishment. So I'd like to point this painting out to you, which was done in plein air, and it's on the quay, one of the quays. I always like the mangroves, and I always like the infinite view that you see in the distance. And in Key West, you've got very shallow water, so you see the colors coming through underneath. And that was done on one day, and then I set it up another day with totally different lighting. I used to stay with a friend of mine in Switzerland, and she was very wealthy and had this wonderful estate, and I used to ask her, can't I just live in a little gate house there? But she didn't agree. But anyway, when I came back home, this was my imagination of that estate. And I always like irises, so irises and rocks were something I would like to paint. I got a little tired of doing attractive flowers and seascapes, so I went to Ringling and studied art and healing, and this is a new technique, what they call touch drawing, and it's tissue paper, and you trace on black ink, you trace the design, and these came out as tissue paper glued on a canvas, and they are very subliminal, psychological, and you paint what you see in them, sort of like a Rorschach test. This one represents to me the barren forest, the barren jungle, and this is me being energized, and then blossoms appear, created for seed. And the other one next door is this one actually is a sort of cleavage in the brain. The right brain has some sinister effect. The female represents a materialistic side to life, and the male figure is in chaos. His thoughts are in chaos, and he's sort of military. And the young man has the symbols of the sickle and hammer, and the swastika. And the young man who's supposed to go to war, and he's throwing up. I always liked visual arts. For a while, since I had to make money, and you don't seem to make a lot of money in painting, I was a film editor. But I was a perennial student. I went to Pratt Institute and Long Island University. Then I lived in Key West, which is the last town in America, but still in the American continent. And I was there for 12 years. And I painted a lot of these paintings there because it was so colorful and so unusual. It kind of delighted me for a while. But now I'm changing to Ringling Brothers and learning these art and healing symbolic psychological renditions, which just seems exciting. So I don't know where this will all lead me.